Namaste and a very warm welcome to my channel Sunshine Tarot. Today's reading is specifically for all the singles out there looking for love. Let's see what's coming up for you in the next couple of days. Please give me a moment while I shuffle and draw the cards. All right, the first card is the Ace of Wands. This card represents whether you are ready or not to embrace new love into your life. The Aces in Tarot are about new beginnings or the potential for a new beginning. Ace of Wands corresponds to fire energy. So in terms of a yes or no, the answer is a yes. Yes. You are ready to embrace new love in your life. This card represents a lot of drive, ambition, passion, and a lot of sexual energy. You are more than ready to embrace new love in your life. The second card is the Knight of Swords. Now, this card represents the qualities you are looking for in a relationship. You know, the knights in tarot are all about change, movement, and action. And swords corresponds to air energy, that is Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. I would say that you are looking at intellectual stimulation in your relationship. You know, you want somebody who is well-read, articulate, well-spoken, who has an opinion of everything in the world, ranging from, you know, world affairs to politics, to, you know, the climate, the environment, sustainability, and so on. You want somebody who will challenge you on an intellectual level. And, you know, you're somebody who would rather sit and have a discussion on a Saturday night instead of walking into a sunset hand in hand. The next card is the Hermit. Now, this card represents what qualities you are looking for in a partner. The Hermit corresponds to Virgo energy, which is earth energy. I would say you are looking for somebody who is mature, wise, and also has a spiritual bent of mind. You want somebody who will shine a light on you and who will lead you forward with his wisdom. So this is interesting because while in a relationship it says you want a lot of intellectual stimulation, in a partner you're also looking for somebody who will balance you out in terms of being very wise and grounded as well as spiritual. The next card is the Queen of Swords. Now this card represents what signs you are likely to see when your soulmate is nearby. For some of you, this person could be a divorcee, a single mom, or somebody who has faced a lot of hardships and heartbreaks. Now, this is a person who has evolved from being a victim at some point in their lives to being victorious. You know, I like to read the Queen of Swords as the boss lady. She knows what it's like to be down and out, but she is also able to get up and fend for herself and own her power. The Queen of Swords is also somebody who is articulate, objective, practical, and rational. And don't be fooled by that, you know, tough exterior, because what lies within is a heart of gold. The last card is the Nine of Cups. And this card represents what you are likely to experience in love by December 2021. You know, the Nine of Cups in tarot is known as the wish fulfillment card. So I would say by December 2021, you are likely to manifest new love into your life or a specific person into your life. Well, this is a very positive reading, and I hope it resonates for all those of you who are, you know, looking for love, because you are ready for love. Depending on the kind of, you know, aura you emit or your vibration, you attract the same kind of people. And because you have a very good aura about you right now, it's likely that you will, you know, attract somebody who will be just the right fit for you. Well, that's all I have for today. I wish you all a very happy Monday. Bye-bye.